Alderley,
Lord Boromir,
Lord Sickert,
and Lord Camp.
With every virtue, every grace,
our water veils the sceptred race. Here you see the four of us, and there are so many more of us, eldest sons, that must succeed. We know how Caesar conquered Gaul and how to whack a cricket ball. Apart from this, our education lacks coordination. Though we're young and tentative and rather representative scions of a noble breed, we are the products of those homes serene and sickly, which only lately seem to have run to seed. The stately homes of England, how beautiful they stand, to prove the upper classes have still the upper hand.
Though the fact that they have to be rebuilt
and frequently mortgaged to the hilt
is inclined to take the guilt off the gingerbread,
and certainly damps the fun of the eldest son.
But still we won't be beaten, we'll scrimp and screw and save. The playing fields of Eton have made us frightfully brave. And though if the Van Dykes have to go and we pawn the next line grand, we'll stand by the stately homes of England.
Pick of us, you may be heartily sick of us, still with sense we're all imbued. Our homes command extensive views, and with assistance from the Jews, we have been able to dispose of rows and rows and rows of Gainsboroughs and Florence's.
Some sporting prints of our Florence's, some of which were rather rude.
Although we sometimes flaunt our family conventions, our good intentions must be misconstrued. The stately homes of England we proudly represent. We only keep them up for Americans to rent.
Though the pipe supply in the bathroom burst, and the lavatory makes you fear the worst, it was used by Charles I, quite informally, and later by George IV, on a journey north.
The state departments keep their historical renown. It's wiser not to sleep there in case they tumble down. But if they ever catch on fire, which with any luck they might, we'll fight for the stately homes of England.
The stately homes of England are rather in the lurch, provide a lot of chances for psychical research.
There's the ghost of a crazy younger son who murdered in 1351 an extremely rowdy nun who resented it.
And people who come to call meet her in the hall.
The baby in the guest wing who crouches by the grate was walled up in the west wing in 1428.
And if anyone spots the Queen of Scots in a hand-embroidered shroud,
we're proud of the stately homes of England. The stately homes of England, although a trifle bleak, historically speaking, are more or less unique.
We've a cousin who won the Golden Fleece, and a very peculiar fowling piece, which was sent to Cromwell's niece, who detested it and rapidly sent it back with a dirty crack.
A note we have from Chaucer contains a bawdy joke.
We also have a saucer which Bloody Mary broke. And we've two pairs of tights King Arthur's knights had completely worn away.
Sing, hey, for the stately homes of England.